Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to Watchbox, and thanks for logging on. If you love this watch, email me, timasso@thewatchbox.com. It's your purchase and pricing email question line in the description below. For buying this or any watch you see on any Watchbox platform, reach out to me directly, timasso@thewatchbox.com. Today, we're discussing a 10-piece limited edition for the 2013 model year in rose gold and white gold. This is the Audemars Piguet Tradition Tourbillon Repetition Minute Chronographe, a timepiece that is all of those things, a tourbillon, a minute repeater, and a chronograph in a bimetallic double gold case. Now, it's 47 millimeters in diameter, but slim at 12.5 millimeters thick, and from lug to lug, 53.9 millimeters. I believe that if you can wear a 47 millimeter Panerai Luminor 1950, you can wear this. They fit exactly the same. Let me pull my sleeve back, give you a better sense of this watch on my wrist. My wrist is 16 centimeters circumference. I could recommend this watch for a wrist as small as 15. I wouldn't go any smaller than that, but you can see it really is quite flat and broad. The lugs are fairly short and stubby, so I think down to 15 centimeters circumference, your wrist should be just fine to wear this watch. It's heavy though. You can really feel where the money went. The strap is impressive. Zoom in real quick. You can see that the strap is black, large rectangular scale alligator leather. It's semi-gloss. It is bolstered a little bit to give it some volume. There's some stuffing inside. There's a monotone black stitch, and then you can see that the side itself is actually folded on the underside. It is a brand new Audemars Piguet factory strap. And in case you ever want to make a strap for this watch in your possession, you'll custom order a 26 millimeter spacing, because that is the distance between the lug horns. The buckle is a lovely high polished red gold Audemars Piguet single fold logo buckle, and the timepiece is handsomely detailed and thoughtfully constructed. As you can see, the lugs are welded on. This is old school case construction with the lugs built separately from the case, welded on, and then evidence of the weld is removed. This is not possible if you're just stamping a case. You can see there's a contrast between polish and satin, between vertical satin and longitudinal satin, between white gold, for example, the chronograph pushers on the crown, and red gold. And then you can see that each part, the bezel in white gold, as well as the mid case in red gold, they have both satin features and polished features. There are also strong character lines that run from the side of the case all the way up to the crystal. And then on the dial of the watch, there is a vertical brushed grain, almost like stainless steel. What you're seeing here is a nickel anthracite color, and it's vertically brushed. Underneath that, you can see there's an old-fashioned minute scale, and then inboard, black-polished rose gold Breguet Arabic numerals. You can also see there are little cabochon indices down at 25 and 35 minutes elapsed. There is a sub-register for the minutes, which is countersunk, and you can see it as a polished rose gold chaptering, and then elaborate hands, beautifully rounded across their tops, and clearly manually finished. The tourbillon regulator sits at the base of the dial, and by the way, this is the minutes register for the chronograph. This is the one-minute tourbillon. It beats away at 21,600 vibrations per hour. It is free sprung for precision. It also features an overcoil hairspring made by hand so that in any position, the hairspring with centered mass will beat concentrically and the watch will keep very regular time. You can see that the entirety of the tourbillon cage, as well as the tourbillon bridge above, black polished with specular or mirrored finish, and that's finished off with diamond paste to create the black polish effect you see right there. Turn it all over. This is a movement that is blessed with, unfortunately, no water resistance, as this is a minute repeater. It's only moisture and dust proof, but then again, you've got an offshore if you want to get wet and wild. This is for those good times high and dry. Audemars Piguet Renoué Papy, which is the high-end movement arm of AP, builds this movement. It is the caliber 2874. It is a tourbillon. It is a column wheel lateral clutch chronograph, and it is a minute repeater with black polished strikers and gongs visible on the reverse side. As you can see, it is adjusted in five positions, which is the high horology and chronometer standard. It pivots on 38 jewels. It is a manual wind 21/6 beat rate movement with a 48-hour power reserve. It has absolutely delightful column wheel feel with lateral clutch action. You can see the lateral clutch horns, recentering hammers, clutch itself, and column wheel all made out of steel. You can see there are immaculate Côte de Genève across the bridges, engine turning on the base plate or perlage, satination on the wheels, black polishing of the screw heads with chamfering of slots and circumference, also black polishing of the strikers. The watch, of course, has a minute repeater, so I need not speak for a watch that can speak for itself. Let's fire this one up. If you want to impress your friends with your minute repeater, you want to set it to 12:59, and I'm going to do my very best to set this to 12:59 right here, right now. Sometimes I miss by a small amount. Nailed it. And as you can see, this is number 9 of 10 constructed. As good as it gets. Reach out to Team Osso at thewatchbox.com for purchase and pricing details.